Hi there, your computer friend Connie here. We're going to talk about approvals in Teams. How can you get an approval on a file within Microsoft Teams? Let's jump into the demo so you can see how this works really quickly. As you can see, I'm in Microsoft Teams and I'm in the Project MC team and the general channel. So I've opened up the files tab of this team and channel. And I want you to notice that I've already done an example of an approval in here. So there's actually a column that says sign off status. This column will appear once you start using the approval feature. It will not appear beforehand and you can't really ask for it. So you see, I have a pending approval on this one file. We're going to do approval from scratch so you can see how it works, and then we're going to show how you can approve anything that comes to you. So as the we'll look at it from the point of view of the sender of the file for getting approved, and as the receiver of the file for getting approved. And from both angles, let's look at how do I find what approvals I've sent off and, you know, where they are, what's the status of them, because you could be doing this in many different teams and channels. Okay, so let's start with the project timeline here. So this particular file, I want to get an approval on. And so I know I said to you that we are going to do approvals in Teams. We're going to start off here, but in actuality, there is, if I go to my little three dots menu here, there isn't an approval option in the Teams menu at this moment in time. Maybe Microsoft will add it in eventually, but at this time, what you're going to do is once you're in the area in Teams that you want to get the approval from, you're going to go to the three dots at the top here and choose to open in SharePoint. Okay, so really the approvals that we're talking about, we could be doing in Teams or in SharePoint. So I'm having you start in Teams, so let's choose to open in SharePoint. All right, so my screen has changed so that I'm in SharePoint now, looking at those same files I was looking at in Teams. So now when I choose Project Timeline and I go to the three dots here, I want to go to Automate. And when I go to Automate, and notice I kind of rested on there for a moment, and it actually popped up Request Sign Off. So that's what we're going to use for this approval process. So I'm going to click on Request Sign Off. So then the sign panel opens up to run a flow. And by the way, mine didn't do this, but if this is the first time you're doing this exercise of asking for approvals, it will show you the apps it needs to run the flow. So it might want to confirm that you're logged in to all of those apps, which is SharePoint approvals and notifications. Okay, so the first thing it asks me is, well, who is the approver? Who do you want to approve this item? And you can have it suggest people. It's really looking at the people within your team environment. If you're looking at this from only SharePoint, then it's whoever's members of your SharePoint site. So I'm going to type in my name. And I do have room to add more approvers if I want to. I'm just going to keep it simple and just have myself. And then you do have to put a message in here. You see how they have the asterisks there? So it is mandatory. Let the approver know why you're having them approve that file. All right, so I have my message typed there. Let's go to the bottom here where it says run flow. And then it says started request sign off flow. Now I happen to be Connie at Mission Computers. So what I want you to see is that there is an actual pop-up that comes up on my screen that says that somebody sent me an approval for request. So I'm playing the sender and the receiver at the same time. So you're seeing it show up as both here. But you see how you're getting notified. So that person that you're asking for approval from will get a notification on their screen saying an approval has been requested. They will also get an email. So let's show you what that email looks like. So here is the email, and you can see from this email, it's giving me a link to the file. So obviously if I'm going to approve the file, I'd want to go look at the file and then pay attention to what kind of message that the sender sent me, so I know what I'm looking for in the file. And then once I've done that, I can just hit one of these buttons, approve or reject. So this stays in my inbox and I can keep it there as long as I want until I approve or reject it. So I'm not going to approve or reject it just yet. I want to actually just show you how this looks in Teams now. So if I go back to Teams, you see that now it shows that project timeline is pending and it shows that in the sign off status. So I know that it hasn't been approved yet. Let me go ahead and approve this. And when I approve it as the approver, I can enter comments as well. This is not mandatory, but let's say I need them to know something about, you know, what I saw in the approval process. Okay, and then I just submit those comments. And it's interesting how it changes the email actually to say approved. So the email doesn't stay the same. It actually makes that look different as well. So I'm going to close this. Now, as a sender of that approval, this is what the sender receives. So they would receive a notice that somebody signed off on their item, and it has a link to that particular file in the email as well. So they can go to it from here if they wish to. Okay, now let's do one more thing. Let's look at it from the point of view of I might have a lot of approvals that I've sent out, and they're from different channels, different teams. So rather than going and clicking around to find them or looking at my emails to find them, there must be a central spot. So I could be saying that as the approver or as the approvee. Okay, so let's go into where that is. Where do I find my approvals that I've sent out or I've received? And I'm taking you into Power Automate now. So I want you to go to your web app from Microsoft 365. And from Microsoft 365, you're gonna go to the waffle at the top left-hand corner there, and you're gonna look for Power Automate. If Power Automate isn't in that list, you're gonna say Explore All Apps to find it. And then once you find it and open it, this is what you're gonna see. So it actually starts at the, if I click on the Home button, this is where it starts. So we want to notice on the left-hand side here, we have approvals. So we're going to click on approvals. So once I get into the approvals area here, I have three places I can look for information. I have received, sent, and history. Received is the approval request I've received that I haven't yet approved. So I have an option here to approve them. So I'll show you in a minute how to do that. Sent is kind of what it sounds like. These are all the approvals I've sent out, and these are sent to other people. So it tells me who I sent them to. So in my case, I've sent them to myself. So just normally you wouldn't be doing that, but pretend that says somebody else. These two are a different email address, and so that's why there's a few extra here. And then history will show you the approvals that have been approved or rejected, in fact. Nothing has been rejected yet, so it doesn't show that as an outcome. But let's do that with one of the received ones. I'll reject one of those, and then you'll see it as a new history item. So I'm going to go to received, and I'm going to go to this one. Please approve evaluation form. Well, if I need a little bit more details than that, because I'm not on the email, I'm not seeing the link, I can just click on the link for this request, and it opens up the panel on the right-hand side here. So it tells me who the requester is, when it was received. It also gives me the link to the actual form, which of course I'd want to check out and make sure I do in fact want to approve it. And then once I've done that, keep in mind I want to see the details as well to see what the requester is sending me. So now below all of that, once I've done my due diligence and I've actually taken a look at everything, I can go here and I can choose whether to approve it, reject it, or even reassign it. I want to give it to somebody else to approve. So that's kind of an interesting option, isn't it? So I'm going to choose reject because I want you to see what that looks like in the history tab. So reject. And then you can add a comment, but again, that is optional. So if you're rejecting, I would suspect that you probably want to add a comment so they understand why you've rejected it. So I'll choose confirm at the bottom. And now it says response successfully recorded. And you see pop-ups on my screen because, again, remember, I'm the one that's the approver and the requester. So the requester is getting notified that it's been rejected. They're also getting an email. So let's take a peek at that email, and then we'll look at how this looks in the history tab. So here's an email, and now notice the subject line says not approved evaluation form. So I'm seeing that right away when I'm looking at my email window. And then when I open it up, it says what happened and then the comment made by that approver. Okay, now back to the actual Power Automate or approvals area. I'm going to close this response, and I'm going to go to the history tab, and that's where I should see my first outcome that says rejected. I have a couple more videos for you to check out about approvals, so be sure to check the link in the description below so that you can learn all that you need to know about this feature and use it to the best of your ability. So this is a great feature within Microsoft Teams that you might want to take advantage of as soon as you can. And as I'm showing it in SharePoint, of course, if you have SharePoint and you're using that for your file management, then use it in there. But let me know your examples that you might have for approvals and how this fits within your world. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.